Now let's study the electric field strength due to a uniformly charged long thread. Say we are given with a straight long thread which is uniformly charged with a positive charge of linear charge density lambda coulomb per meter. This is given as a linear charge density of the thread or this wire which is straight. And we can directly state that as being positively charged, electric field in its surrounding will be in radially outward direction such that it is originating from the thread. Now, say at a distance r from the thread, there is a point P where we wish to find out the electric field strength, certainly which is existing in the direction away from the thread. Now, to calculate this electric field at a distance y, from the point O, we consider a small element of a dy. Certainly on this element charge dq will be lambda dy, as lambda is linear charge density. And this small element can be taken as a point charge due to which say electric field at point P will be in the direction away from this point charge. Say this electric field is D. So we can write electric field due to dq at P is, this can be written as dE, which is given by the result of a point charge. This is k dq by this distance square, which is root of r square plus y square. So this is k dq by r square plus y square. Now if we integrate it from one end of the thread to the other, the direction of this dE will change. So here again we resolve this d into two mutually perpendicular components. If this angle is theta, this will be d cos theta, and here this is d sin theta. Obviously, as all sin theta components due to the lower thread are in upward direction and due to the upper thread are in downward direction, these will cancel each other. So we can write net electric field at point P is EP, which is integration of dE cos theta. If we substitute the value of dE, it will be k dq can be written as lambda dy upon r square plus y square. Into here cos theta we can substitute as r upon root of r square plus y square, and limits of integration we substitute that for y. And as being a long thread, we substitute limits from minus infinity to plus infinity. So this expression I just shifted due to a space. Here this EP will be integration from minus infinity to plus infinity. It is k lambda r multiplied by dy upon r square plus y square to power 3 by 2. Here we can easily integrate it by trigonometric substitution. We take let y is equals to r tan theta. If we substitute, this gives dy is r sec square theta d theta. Let's see if we substitute these values over here. We can also change the limits, like at y is equals to minus infinity, this will result theta is minus pi by 2. And y is equals to plus infinity, theta will be plus pi by 2. Now if we change the limits, we'll get a simplified form of integrand. Let's continue on the next sheet. Now if we just substitute the values in the expression, here you can rewrite the integrand as we can change the limits from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. This will be k lambda dy, we can substitute as r sec square theta d theta, divided by denominator we substitute y as r tan theta. This will be r cube sec cube theta. So here r cube and this r square, sec square theta and cube gets cancelled out. So the result will be, here I can take k lambda as a constant out. It will be from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. This r will also come out. This will be cos theta d theta. If I integrate this term cos theta, it will be sin theta within limits from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So this will be k lambda by r. On substituting the values, it will be 1 minus of minus 1. So the result of Ep will be 2k lambda by r. That is the result of electric field strength due to a uniformly charged long thread at a distance r from it.